Exceed.
Exceedingly.
So, if I get that off the wall, the distance of that plus the skirting, then I can wedge it off the face of that. So. Okay, so that was a little bit stressful, but we've got it done. Got a couple of battens on the end just to pull them ends tight through the veneers past the mitre joint, so it's nice and consistent where we're going to be joining it into that next piece. On the whole, it's gone pretty well. There is a few gaps in the veneers at the top. I brought the stuff to do it, but I didn't do it. I'm a bit disappointed in myself. But I'd like to squeeze an extra bit of glue on every veneer joint on this top edge, so we definitely got a good glue squeeze out the top and I didn't do it, so that's a little bit annoying. So we're gonna unload the van and go and explore Manchester for the day. That was pretty good. just using these leveling battens. Here we go, the death machine fired up. Went really well. There's a little bit of a wobble in it in one place, but I think it'll sand out. But I forgot to press record on the camera while I machined it. There's a few little gaps in laminations as well. A little bit of a blue line there, that a tiny gap that will need some filler, but that looks really good. I'm so pleased to get to this stage. It's beautiful. Bit of a wobble just there. Thank you. So just cutting up these bits for the fire, and give a good cross section actually of how the laminations have ended up. You can see the two little strips I put the back to negate the fact that the plaster was deeper or further into the room. I'm just going to tilt the skirting board or leave a big gap at the top. So they've just filled that gap by adding them two bits on. Really, really happy with that. It's just perfect, isn't it?